at question number 713 about 7th also second time revaluation but depreciable assets. Question number second one also, question number 7 also second time revaluation but it has given depreciable assets. If it has given depreciable assets, net book value should be compared with revaluation amounts and given trial balance. Additional information it has given previous loss also. First one, read and get idea. Trial balance is given 31st March 2021. It has given trial balance 31st March 2021. If it has given depreciable assets, net book value should be compared with revaluation amounts. Think what fair value is given. Fair value mean previous year revaluation amounts, first time revaluation amounts. It may be previous year or before that. That is a first year revaluation amounts. And given building revaluation loss 8,000 was recognized when building was revalued first time. It had been considered as expense also. Think about this is the this year revaluation amounts, 31st March 2021, end of the year. Building is a non-depreciable assets, depreciable. But given fair value, if it has given fair value, this is not first time revaluation. And given first time revaluation loss also given. But accumulated depreciation is given opening balance. Accumulated depreciation is given opening balance. End of the revaluation. It has given end of the revaluation. Therefore, net book value should be compared with revaluation amounts. Think about there were previous loss. Right. Prepare work in. Compare with net book value and revaluation amounts. Net book value should be compared with revaluation amounts if it has given depreciable assets. Therefore, net book value net book value and revaluation amount should be compared. Now try to calculate net book value. Net book value and revaluation amounts. Net book value equal. Now it has not given fair value. Now it has not given cost value. It has given first time revaluation amounts. Therefore, cost or fair value. Fair value mean revaluation amounts. Cost value or first time revaluation amounts. It is fair value. From that value should be deduct accumulated depreciation. Cost of fair value. Now it has not even cost value. Try to calculate net book value and compare with revaluation amounts. It has given accumulated depreciation beginning of the year. Therefore, you have to calculate from the beginning annual depreciation also. Now cannot be calculated based on cost value. You have to calculate based on first year depreciation amounts. First time depreciation amounts. Annual depreciation should be calculated based on first time revaluation amounts. Cost value is not given. After revaluation, depreciation also should be calculated based on revaluation amounts, not based on cost value. Therefore, annual depreciation now, cost value is not given. Think how to calculate. Annual depreciation always cannot be calculated based on cost value. There's MCQ paper. If it has given revaluation, after revaluation, based on revaluation amounts, depreciation should be calculated. End of the revaluation. Therefore, you have to consider annual depreciation also. Think about sometime it has given beginning of the revaluation, sometime it has given end of the revaluation. Therefore, fair value, cost value equal to 1000. Fair value mean first time revaluation amounts. Based on that value should be calculated now. Based on that value, 10% equal to 20,000. This is annual depreciation. Then think about net book value. Cost value is not given. Given first time revaluation amounts. From that value deduct accumulated depreciation. As accumulated depreciation deduct closing balance. Opening balance it has given 60,000 plus annual depreciation 20,000. Therefore, cost minus, now cost value is not given, first time revaluation amounts, from that value minus accumulated depreciation. Therefore, accumulated net book value as at the revaluation date equal 120,000, but revaluation amount is given 135,000. Thing annual depreciation also we have to add it. Reason end of the revaluation. If it has given beginning of the revaluation, only opening balance can be deducted. Therefore, this is the net book value. And now revaluation are higher than the net book value. First one recognize this year profit and loss. Therefore, net book value revaluation are higher than the net book value. Therefore, profit. Difference value should be considered as a profit. Difference value should be considered as a profit. Think about difference value. Profit equal. Difference value profit equal 15,000. This is a revaluation surplus. Revaluation profit, it is equal surplus. Think about building is a depreciable assets. Second time revaluation. Now within this surplus, how to records? There were previously loss also available. Normally surplus should be include other comprehensive income. But now total value cannot be include other comprehensive income. You have to consider previous loss also. Think about revaluation surplus effect for building increase. Therefore, think about it is effect for building accounts. Building accounts and revaluation reserves accounts. Revaluation reserves account. As well as profit and loss, income statement. Income statement, amount equal for previous loss should be recorded income statement. Effect for building increase, therefore building account debit. Effect for building increase, therefore building account debit. Normally revaluation surplus should be included under revaluation reserves accounts. That value should be included under other comprehensive income. That value should be included under other comprehensive income. Other comprehensive income. Normally, revaluation profit should be included under other comprehensive income. But now, total value cannot be included. Reason there were previously loss available. First time revaluation loss, it has given 8,000. ඒ පාර loss එකක් තිබිලා තියෙන හින්දා මේ පාර profit එක අපි ඔක්කොම දාන්න බෑ other comprehensive income වල amount equal for previous loss මේ පාර profit එකෙන් ගිය පාර loss එකට equal ප්‍රමාණයක් within brackets under other expense income statement ඔන්න මේ පාර profit එක record කරනකොට ගිය පාර loss එකක් තිබිලා තියෙන හින්දා एक आयिंग कराना नहीं था नहीं एक तीन आधे एक्सपेंस लगी पर गिल दिन देखो अंड आधे एक्सपेंस अंड आधे एक्सपेंस इनकम स्टेटमेंट अंड आधे एक्सपेंस विद इन बैकेट शुड बी रिकॉर्ड्स विद इन बैकेट्स ओनली बैलेंस पार्ट शुड बी इंक्लूड अंड आधे कंपनीज इनकम बट इफेक्ट फॉर बिल्डिंग इंक्रीज टोटल वैल्यू 15,000 टोटल 15,000 इफेक्ट फॉर बिल्डिंग इंक्रीज Therefore, building account debit 15,000, revaluation reserves account credit 7,000, and income statement credit 8,000. Amount equal for previous loss. Income statement credit, revaluation reserves account credit, building account debit. But when we are going to record in the income statement, amount equal for previous loss when recording this year profit should be included within brackets. මේ පාර ප්‍රොෆිට් එක තමයි රෙකෝඩ් කරන්න යන්නේ. ගිය පාර ලොස් එකක් තිබිලා තියෙන හින්දා තමයි මෙතන අපි දාන්නේ. ගිය පාර ලොස් එකට ඊක්වල් ප්‍රමාණයක් මේ පාර ප්‍රොෆිට් එකෙන්. බැලන්ස් පාර්ට්ස් බින්ක් උඩන්ඩ අදර් කම්පියන්ස් ඉන්කම්. Therefore double entry building account debit revaluation reserves account credit as less income statement credit. Income statement. ගිය පාර ලොස් එකට ඊක්වල් ප්‍රමාණයක් එතනින් අපි අයින් කරන්න ඕන. Then prepare ledger account also. Think about double entry. Think which account debit, which account credit. Revaluation building account debit and revaluation reserves account credit as well as income statement credit. Building is a depreciable assets. Therefore, normally there are three steps to be applied. First one annual depreciation, second one accumulated depreciation, third one revaluation profit and loss. Right, prepare the ledger accounts. There are four ledger accounts. Think how to disclose in the ledger account also. Think about this year profit previous loss. This year profit previous loss. Therefore, prepare the building accounts. Balance also given. Building accounts and accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation of building. As well as income statement. Income statement and revaluation reserves accounts. Revaluation reserves account also. Revaluation reserves. First one, take the balances. Previous year loss, this year profit. Think how it records. Building account balance available 21,000. And accumulated depreciation also given 60,000. Think end of the revaluation. Sometime it has given beginning of the revaluation. Annual depreciation should be recorded. Total depreciation should be removed from accumulated depreciation to asset accounts. Third one, revaluation profit and loss should be recorded. Let first one take the balance building and accumulated depreciation. Building account asset debit side balance brought forward. As a balance brought forward, as well as accumulated depreciation also credit side as given balance, as a balance brought forward. Step number one, annual depreciation. This is the first steps. Think about steps also. Step number one, and second one, accumulated depreciation. This is second steps, and third one revaluation profit and loss. Normally there are three steps to be applied. First one annual depreciation should be recorded. Second one accumulated depreciation should be recorded. Third one revaluation surplus. Normally three steps should be applied. annual depreciation, depreciation expense account debit, accumulated depreciation account credit. 20,000 recorded. Depreciation expense account debit. You have to prepare separate ledger account as a depreciation expense also. Depreciation expense account debit. Depreciation expense. Balance available in the accumulated depreciation accounts. First one thing, annual depreciation. Value equal to 20,000. Depreciation expense account debit. Accumulated depreciation account credit. Therefore, accumulated depreciation credit as a building depreciation. Building depreciation account debit as a accumulated depreciation. Step number one. Think there are three steps to be applied. Second steps, total depreciation 80,000 should be transferred to the asset accounts. Think about accumulated depreciation 80,000. As at the revaluation date, it should be transferred from accumulated depreciation to building accounts. Therefore, accumulated depreciation account debit, building account credit. Record it. Total value equal 80,000. Accumulated depreciation account debit, building account credit. This is a building accounts. Name of other ledger accounts. Therefore, here as a description, name of other ledger accounts. Accumulated depreciation account debit as a building accounts. This is a second step. Accumulated depreciation account debit, building account credit. Now record revaluation surplus. Think about previous year loss also available. Revaluation surplus equal 15,000. Effect for building increase. Total value building account debit, but credit to ledger accounts. Revaluation reserves account credit balance part. Amount equal for previous year loss income statement credit. Therefore, separately debit building accounts. 7,000 building account debit, revaluation reserves account credit. 8,000 building account debit, income statement credit. Separately, but total value equal 15,000 effect for building increase. Should be recorded separately. 7,000 as less 8,000. Therefore, building account debit 7,000 as a revaluation reserves. As a revaluation reserves. As less 8,000 as a income statement. Things should be recorded separately. Third steps, effect for building increase 15,000, but when we are going to record, should be recorded separately. This is third steps, effect for building increase. Therefore, building account should be debit 15,000. And credit separately. Revaluation reserves account credit 7,000. Income statement credit 8,000. Therefore, amount equal for previous year loss income statement credit as a building. And revaluation reserves account credit balance bar as a building, name of other ledger accounts. Think about income statement credit. That value should be included under other expense within brackets. This value cannot be included other income, other expense within brackets. That is the way we have records. Right, normally three steps. If it has correctly recorded, building account closing balance should be equal revaluation amounts. Take credit side total amount, debit side total amounts. Debit side increase, take that value credit side, and difference value balance carry down. Therefore, this one minus this one, take the answer. difference value balance carried out equal 135,000. If it is correct, that value should be equal revaluation amounts. As a balance carried down, definitely they ask in the paper, you have to get ready for that. Think about depreciable asset, non-depreciable assets. And first time, second time. If it has correctly recorded, think about balances. Therefore, this is the building account balance. And depreciation should be closed. Both side equal. So debit side increase. Take that value credit side. Difference value income statement. Therefore, this is the closing entry. Income statement. This value should be included under administration expense, building depreciation. And accumulated depreciation, think about if it has given end of the revaluation, closing balance zero. But if it has given beginning of the revaluation, closing balance, annual depreciation became a closing balance. If it has given end of the revaluation, there is no balance. If it has given beginning of the revaluation, annual depreciation equal closing balance of accumulated depreciation. Then this value should be included under other expense within brackets. This value should be recorded under other comprehensive income. Think about previous sale of this year profit, depreciable asset, end of the revaluation. Cost value is not given. Think about cost model and revaluation model. Those are accounting policies. Property, plant, and equipment can be disclosed by using cost model as well as revaluation model. Next one. Last question relevant for revaluation part. Last question relevant for revaluation part. After this, I will discuss 2020 year old paper MCQ question also relevant for revaluation part. Think about this one, 8. Trial balance is given 31st March 21. Building, it has given fair value, not given cost value. Therefore, this asset already revalued. And given accumulated depreciation also, accumulated depreciation, and trial balance available, building revaluation reserves accounts. What is the meaning? There were previous year revaluation surplus. There were revaluation surplus. First time. Then building were revalued second time for first. It has given 405,000. Values in 1,000. End of the year. Think about this is a second time revaluation. Now cannot be compared with cost value. First time there were revaluation surplus available. One of them gear power profit take up the bill. May power loss take up avot. Mokadha karanakila theory known. Right, you have to calculate by comparing net book value and revaluation amounts. First one, calculation should be done. Net book value should be compared with revaluation amounts. This is the depreciable assets. Net book value equal cost minus accumulated depreciation. It should be compared with revaluation amounts. Now, cost value is not given. It has given fair value. Fair value means first time revaluation amounts. Therefore, carrying amounts, net book value equal cost or fair value. Cost or fair value. Cost or fair value. Cost of fair value. Sometime it has given cost value, sometime it has given fair value. From that value should be deducted accumulated depreciation. Cost of fair value. If it has given revaluation, cost value is not available. as a fair value, it has given revaluation amounts first time. Right, first time revaluation amount equal to 1000 and deduct accumulated depreciation. It has given opening balance, but revaluation is given end of the year. Therefore, from the beginning, annual depreciation also should be calculated. Annual depreciation also should be calculated. Annual depreciation. Therefore, annual depreciation based on previous year revaluation amounts. First time revaluation amounts to 1000, not cost value. Percentage is given 10%. Think how to calculate annual depreciation. That value also should be added to the opening balance. End of the revaluation. Cost minus as accumulated depreciation, 60,000 opening balance plus annual depreciation, 20,000. Therefore, 200,000 minus accumulated depreciation, 80,000. Therefore, net book value equal 120,000. It should be compared with revaluation amounts, 105,000. Now, revaluation amount lower than the net book value. Revaluation amount lower than the net book value. Think about revaluation amount lower than the net book value. Therefore, difference value should be considered as a revaluation loss. Therefore, difference value should be considered as a revaluation loss. Therefore, think about difference value. Revaluation amount lower than the net book value. Therefore, difference value should be considered as a loss. Therefore, revaluation loss equal difference value 15,000. Deficits. That is a revaluation deficits. Revaluation deficit mean loss. Revaluation deficit equal loss equal. $15,000. This is the revaluation loss. Now think about second time loss. It has given reserves account balance available. It means there were first time surplus available. Now think how to record this year loss. There were first time surplus also available. Right, 15,000 loss, but previous year surplus equal 4,000. Therefore, this one should be recorded separately now. Think about which account debit, which account credit. Which account debit, which account credit. Loss effect for building decrease. Therefore, effect for building decrease, building account credit. Effect for building decrease, therefore building account think about. As well as there were previous surplus available, it is available revaluation reserves. It is effect revaluation reserves accounts. And balance part should be included income statement. Normally, loss should be included income statement. Revaluation loss should be included income statement. Right now, think how to record this year loss. This year loss equal 15,000. Effect for building decrease. Therefore, total value effect for building credit. Value equal 15,000. Asset decrease. Normally, loss should be record income statement under other expense. But now, there were previous surplus available. Therefore, when recording this year loss, amount equal for previous surplus should be removed from reserves accounts. should be removed from reserves accounts. Remove. That value should be included under other comprehensive income. And other comprehensive and other comprehensive income within brackets. Think when recording this year profit, this year loss. May par loss එක record කරන කොට ගිය පාර profit එකක් තිබිලා තියෙන හින්දා ගිය පාර profit එකට equal ප්‍රමාණයක් මේ පාර loss එකෙන් other comprehensive income within brackets. Balance parts should be included in income statement under other expense as expense only 11,000. Under other expense. Under other expense. Under other expense. Under other expense should be included only 11,000. Think what as expense. Revaluation loss normally expense. But when we are going to records, it should be recorded separately. Kiyapara profit ekak tibila thiyena hinda okkoma danna bae ada expense wala. Amount equal for previous year surplus. When recording this year loss, amount equal for previous year surplus and other comprehensive income within brackets. Balance part should be included under other expense. Therefore, debit, revaluation reserves accounts. As less debit income statement. There are two ledger account debit now, but total value effect for building decrease. Therefore, building account credit total 15,000. And think about debit which accounts. Normally should be debit profit and loss accounts, but there were previously surplus available. Then think about which account debit, which account credit. Previous year profit, this year loss. Have I them? Chutta kaagana methana. Very well out metan loss එක මේ ගිය පාර surplus එකට වඩා අඩුවෙන් ආවොත් දැන් අපි නිකන් හිතමු මෙතන 3000 ආවේ කියලා මේ පාර loss එක 3000 ආවේ කියලා නිකන් හිතන්නකෝ එහෙනම් 3000 කෙලින්ම යන්නේ other comprehensive income within brackets ගිය පාර profit එක 4000 වුණාට මේ පාර loss එක අඩුයි නම් මේ පාර loss එක විතරයි record කරන්නේ මම ඒක වෙනම ගානක් හදන්න තව ටිකක් Very important. මේම බෙදිලා යන්නේ ගිය පාර surplus එකට වඩා මේ පාර loss එක වැඩි නම්. Right. Then think how to record in the ledger accounts. Step number 1, annual depreciation. Normally 3 steps should be applied. Step number 2, accumulated depreciation as at the reversion date. And step number 3, revaluation loss. Normally three steps should be applied. Normally three steps should be applied. Think what first one annual depreciation. And second one total depreciation. And third one revaluation loss deficits. Think we have to apply there are three steps. Prepare the ledger account also. Building accounts, building accounts. There are five ledger accounts you have to prepare. Building account balance also given, and revaluation reserves, depreciation expense accounts. First one building. Depreciation expense accounts. As well as accumulated depreciation of building. Accumulated depreciation of building. And revaluation reserves accounts. Revaluation reserves accounts. Revaluation reserves accounts. As income statement. In what there are five ETA account you have to prepare. Accumulated depreciation balance also available, as well as building account balance available. First and real estate reserves also balance it is given. Revaluation reserves account also given balance. Right, first one take the balances. Building account 21,000. Accumulated depreciation 60,000. Revaluation reserves account 4,000. Record balance building account 21,000. As a balance brought forward. And accumulated depreciation account credit side 60,000. As a balance brought forward. And revaluation reserves account also given balance 4,000. As a balance brought forward. Then first one, annual depreciation should be recorded. Annual depreciation, it has given 20,000 calculated. This is annual depreciation. And second one, accumulated depreciation. Annual depreciation 20,000, accumulated depreciation 80,000, and revaluation deficit equal 15,000. Right now, recording the ledger accounts. First one, annual depreciation 20,000. Depreciation expense account debit. Accumulated depreciation account credit. Name of other ledger account description. Think about accumulated depreciation credit as a building depreciation. This is step number one. Second one, total depreciation equal 80,000. End of the revaluation. Therefore, total depreciation should be transferred to the asset accounts. 80,000. Therefore, accumulated depreciation account debit 80,000. Building account credit 80,000. Therefore, building account credit as accumulated depreciation. An accumulated depreciation account debit as a building. First step number one, annual depreciation. Building depreciation expense account debit. Accumulated depreciation account credit. Second one, accumulated depreciation should be removed. Accumulated depreciation account debit. Building account credit. Second steps. Then third one, revaluation surplus. So revaluation loss. Think about loss equal 15,000. Building account credit loss 15,000. But profit and loss account debit only 11,000. Amount equal for previous profit. Amount equal for previous profit should be debit reserves account 4,000. We are going to record this year loss. There were previous year, so first time realization surplus also available. Therefore, when recording loss, normally loss should be debit income statement, but there were previous year surplus. Therefore, amount equal for previous year surplus, reserves account debit. Therefore, building account credit separately. 11,000 as income statement. 11,000 as income statement, as well as 4,000 as revaluation reserves. As income statement, think about third steps. As well as 4,000 as revaluation. Revaluation reserves. Think third steps. Building account credit, income statement debit, revaluation reserves account debit. But total value, think about credit 15,000 should be recorded separately. Therefore, reverse and reserve account debit amount equal for previous surplus as a building. As well as income statement debit balance part 11,000 as a building. Think about this one should be recorded under the expense. And 4,000 should be recorded other comprehensive income within brackets. This year loss, previous year profit. Think how to record this year loss. Amount equal for previous profit, other comprehensive income within brackets. And balance part should be included under other expense. Menne mewa bedala danna puluwan ne apita. Giye para surplus ekata wada me para loss ekak wedi na. Bari welawat metana tiyena loss ekak meeta wada adu unoth. Den api hitoma metana 3000 loss ekak awi kiyala nikan hitanna ko. එතර කෙරෙම බිල් එන එකක් ක්‍රෙඩිට් 3000 රිවර්ස් ඇන්ඩ් රිසර්ව්ස් එකක් ඩෙබිට් 3000 එතකොට ඉන්කම් ස්ටේට්මන්ට් එක යන්නේ නැහැ මෙහෙම බෙදිලා යන්නේ ගිය පාර සර්ප්ලස් එකට වඩා මේ පාර ලොස් එක වැඩි වුණොත් විතරයි බැරි වෙලාවත් මෙතන ආපු ලොස් එක මීට වඩා අඩු වුණොත් අපි නිකන් හිතමු 3000 කියලා එතර බිල් ඉන් එකක් ක්‍රෙඩිට් and revaluation reserves account debit 3000 මේ පාර loss එක තමයි record කරන්න අපි ගිය පාර profit එක කීය වුණත් මේම බෙදිලා යන්නේ මේ පාර loss එක අඩුයි වැඩි ගිය පාර surplus එකට වඩා බැරි වෙලාවත් මේ පාර ආපු loss එක අඩු වුණොත් එම එහෙනම් අපි නිකන් හිතමු example එකකට 3000 කියලා එහෙම වුණොත් building එකක් credit 3000 revaluation reserves account debit 3000 එනම් 3000 විතරයි යන්නේ එහෙම වුණොත් right but previous year surplus equal in this example 4000 and this year loss equal 15000 එතකොට මේ බෙදිලා යන්නේ මේ පාර loss එක ගිය පාර profit එකට වඩා වැඩි නම් විතරයි right now see the question number last year paper think about mcq paper Question number 2 and 3 it has given. Think about this example. Question number 23. This is the 2020 year-old paper. Think what would be the answer. Try to answer this one. Read carefully. Think what would be the answer. Think about recommend. This is a 2020 year old paper. The profit and other comprehensive income for the year end 31st March 20. Hadan try ekak denna issaram. it has given profit and other comprehensive income for the year end 31st March 20. Profit equal 1.5 million and other comprehensive income 800,000 respectively. It has given other comprehensive income represent the surplus of 800,000 resulting from the revaluation of land and building for the second time during the current year. Think what? Revaluation and other comprehensive income include 800,000. It is equal second time revaluation surplus. Total value cannot be included, but it has considered as a total comprehensive income resulted from revaluation of land and building for the second time during the current year. And given revaluation of land and building for the first time on 31st March 16 had resulted deficits 350,000. There were first time loss. This year profit equal 800,000. But profit calculated, those are not considered yet. That's correct profit and total comprehensive income. Now think about revaluation surplus this year 800,000, how to record. This is the last year paper. Last year MCQ paper. Right. First one, think about this year revaluation surplus, how to record. This year revaluation surplus equal 800,000. This year revaluation surplus. Current year revaluation surplus. Revaluation surplus mean profit. Current year revaluation surplus. Current year revaluation surplus equal, it has given 800,000. Think about this is second time revaluation surplus. There were previous deficits. Amount equal for previous, let's think about. If it is deficit, it had been considered as expense. Think about income statement. Income statement as well as revaluation reserves. Think about how much should be included income statement and other expense. Think how much should be included under other expense in the income statement, and think how much should be included under other comprehensive income. Other comprehensive think how much should be included on other comprehensive income. This year surplus, normally surplus should be included revaluation reserves account in the income statement and other comprehensive income. But this year surplus equal 800,000 and previous year deficit equal 350,000. Now then, how to record this year surplus? Normally surplus should be included other comprehensive income normally, if it is first time. But if it is second time, if there were previous year loss, amount equal for previous year loss should be recorded under other expense within brackets. Think about surplus normally should be included other comprehensive income, but there were first time loss available. 350,000. When recording this year surplus, amount equal for first time loss 350,000 should be recorded under other expense within brackets. Only balance part should be included under other comprehensive income. Only this part should be included under other comprehensive income. Therefore, they ask correct profit. Profit already calculated. those are not considered, and there's total compass income also. Profit plus other compass income equal total compass income. First one, try to calculate correct net profit. Correct net profit they ask. Therefore, profit already calculated 1500. Then think about correct net profit. Correct net profit. Profit, it has given all the calculated value. Profit already calculated 1.5 million. Profit already calculated. Profit already calculated. Value it has given 1.5 million. This is profit calculated already, but this one has not been considered. Revaluation surplus normally should be included other compass income, but there were previous loss available. It has not considered. Now think, amount equal for previous loss should be record other expense within brackets. Think if it has include other expense within brackets, expense for mokada wenne kiyala hitanna balanna. Amount equal for previous year loss. When we are going to record this year profit, may par profit ek record karna kota, year par loss ek equal pramanaya, other expense within brackets should be included. Ethara expense la brackets la damma, expense ek adu wenawa. Expense ek adu unoth, profit ek wedi wenawa. Therefore, 350,000 effect for profit increase. Revaluation surplus. Revaluation surplus amount equal for previous loss. Revaluation surplus amount equal for previous year loss. First time loss. Revaluation surplus amount equal for previous loss, amount equal for first time loss should be included, and expense within brackets. Therefore, expense decrease, effect for profit increase. Therefore, this is the correct net profit. Correct net profit equal 1,850,000. This is a correct net profit. Paper. Therefore, this is a correct net profit. First requirements. Then there's total compass income also. Therefore, correct net profit plus other compass income equal net profit plus other compass income equal total compass income. There's total compass income also. Then think under other comprehensive income should be recorded only 450,000. Therefore, under other compass income, under other comprehensive income, you have to consider as other compass income only 450,000. Under other compass income as a 450,000. Then, correct net profit, profit for the year, it is equal profit for the year. Profit for the year plus other comprehensive income equal total comprehensive income. Total comprehensive income. Therefore, take total comprehensive income equal 2,300. This one plus this one, 2,300. Think about requirements. 2020 paper, MCQ. They ask profit for the year and total comprehensive income. Therefore, total comprehensive income equal 2,300 and correct net profit equal 1,850. Therefore, answer is 5. Think what second time revaluation they ask. Revaluation surplus normally should be include other comprehensive income. Revaluation reserves accounts. Loss normally should be include other expense. Income statement. If it is first time. But if it is second time, you have to consider previous year profit and loss also. Right. As reason for revaluation, to maintain qualitative characteristic of relevancy. As a result of revaluation, historical cost concept is violated. And then next one. Next one, think about. Next adjustment. Next one, relevant for leasing part. Leasing. Question on ninth one. I will discuss question on nine. After that, I will discuss EPF part. First one, think about process. How to record leasing adjustment. In the paper it has given, part of adjustment has been recorded. First one, read and get idea. Think about leasing adjustment when business going to purchase asset under finance lease. Mulima mukadi venne kiyala balannako. Api yana leasing company asset ekak ganna. Ethara apita kiyanne mukadi egollo? මුලින්ම down payment එකක් ගෙවන්න. ඉතුරු ටික තමයි lease base එකට දෙන්න බලන්න. කෙලින්ම අපිට දෙන්නේ නැහැ නිකන් asset එක. අපිට motor vehicle එකක් එනවා. අපි කොටසක් ගෙවනවා. ඉතුරු ටික ගෙවන්නේ නැහැ අද. That is a liability lease credit. ඉතුරු ටික ගෙවන්නේ වාරික විදියට. Therefore think about down payment, initial lease liability, current interest, installment and annual depreciation. You have to think like that. Think about first one, down payments. Second one, initial lease liability. Third one, current year interest. Fourth one, current year lease installment. As well as after that, annual depreciation. If it has given lease in adjustment, this is the way you have to think. First one, think about down payments. First one, down payment, think about how records. Down payments. Second one, initial lease liability. This is the way you have to think if it has given lease in adjustment. Initial lease liability. Initial lease liability. It is equal present value of minimum lease payments. Present value. Initial lease liability. Then third one, current year lease interest. Then exam ekek me lease accounts okkoma apita gagahina welawak na. මෙන්න මේ විදිහට හිතුවොත් තමයි accounts ගහන්න තු හදන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්නේ. Down payment, initial lease liability, then current year lease interest. Current year lease interest. After that fourth steps, current year lease installment. Current year lease installment. Current year lease installment. Think where we have records. What would be the double end? Think about. Then fifth one, annual depreciation. annual depreciation if asset purchase beginning of the year or previous year. You have to calculate annual depreciation also. Think about ownership of asset is passed or not to the leasing company, to the lessee, from leasing company to the lessee. Lessee mean company, our business. Lessor mean leasing company. Lessee mean asset purchase karana company. This is the way you have to think if it has given leasing adjustment. Down payment paid in cash to the down payment should be paid cash account credit, motor vehicle account debit. Down payment, cash account credit, motor vehicle account debit. Initial lease liability, motor vehicle account debit, lease credit or credit. Then think about current interest. Down payment, think about double entry also. Asset account debit. Assets account, it may be motor vehicle. Asset account debit. Asset account debit and cash account credit. Asset account debit, cash account credit, down payments. Then second one, initial lease liability, asset account debit. Asset, it may be motor vehicle, it may be building, any asset purchase under finance lease. Asset account debit and lease credit or credit. Leasing company, that value should be paid to the leasing company. Therefore, lease creditor. Lease credit or credit. This is second steps, initial lease liability. Then second one, current interest. Current interest became expense. That value also should be paid to the leasing company. Therefore, lease interest expense accounts. Lease interest expense account debit. Lease interest expense account debit. And lease credit or credit. Interest also we have to pay to the leasing company. Lease creditor, lease creditor credit. Think about double entries. Lease interest also we have to pay to the leasing company. Then current lease installment paid in cash to the leasing company. Therefore, cash account credit, lease creditor debit. Therefore, lease creditor. Lease credit debit and cash account credit. Paid in cash. Cash account credit. Lease credit debit, cash account credit. Annual depreciation. Depreciation expense account debit. Accumulated depreciation account credit. Therefore, depreciation expense accounts. Depreciation expense account debit and accumulated depreciation account credit. Accumulated depreciation account credit. Think how to record annual depreciation. This is the step you have to apply if it has given lease in adjustment. Lease. Think asset purchase under finance lease. How to record in the ledger accounts. And think about question number one. Normally five steps should be applied. Leasing definitely they ask in the paper. Think about substance or form concept. Also you have to think about. Substance or form. Legal requirement. Think about lease asset. There is no legal ownership. But it should be considered as asset based on substance or form concepts. Let's see the question number 9. It has given company aqua motor vehicle. First one, read and get idea. Try to recognize down payment, initial lease liability, current interest, and current installment. Eka gana am making hadanne. That company aqua motor vehicle on 1st April 20 under finance lease for use in the distribution of goods. On this date, fair value of motor vehicle equal fair value, that is a market value equal 12 million. And down payment 4 million has to be paid. Think about down payment 4 million. It means difference value 8 million, that is a payable amounts. It is called initial lease liability. Therefore, initial lease liability equal payable amounts. Not 12,000, not 4,000. 8,000 difference value. And given further annual lease installment, 2.5 million. And lease term of motor vehicle is given 4 years. And expected lifetime is given 5 years. Think how to calculate depreciation now. Lifetime and lease period is changed. In this situation, you have to consider ownership of asset is passed or not. The ownership of motor vehicle is not passed to the company at the end of the lease term. Ownership is not passed. If ownership is not passed, how to calculate depreciation? ඔන ගොඩාක් ළමයි වරද්ද ගන්නවා මෙතන ownership එක pass වෙන්නේ නැත්නම් when we are going to calculate depreciation we have to use ඔන ගොඩාක් ළමයි හිතාගෙන ඉන්නේ lease period එක කියලා it is not correct if ownership is not passed to the company at the end of the lease period when we are going to calculate depreciation we have to use think about ownership is passed If ownership is passed, when we are going to calculate depreciation, you have to use lifetime. When we are going to calculate depreciation, very important this theory. When calculating annual depreciation, and it first one. If ownership of asset is passed to the company. Very, very important. Godak unabana mithana lakunak thiyena paper eke. If ownership of asset. If ownership of asset is passed to the company. Passed to the company at the end of the lease period. At the end of the lease period, if ownership is passed, at the end of the lease period, depreciation should be calculated by dividing useful lifetime. Useful lifetime should be used when calculating annual depreciation. If ownership of asset is passed at the end of the lease period, use lifetime. Use lifetime. It means cost minus residual value divided by useful lifetime. Use lifetime. But if ownership of asset is not passed to the company, if ownership of asset is not passed at the end of the lease period, then how to calculate depreciation? Use lower period. Anivaram lease period claim can be added. But if ownership is passed, definitely use for lifetime. But if ownership is not passed, if ownership is not passed, use lower period of useful lifetime and lease period of useful lifetime. Very important. of useful lifetime and lease period. Very, very important. If ownership is not passed, definitely not lease period. Lower period you have to consider, lower period, right? But here it has given lower period, lease period. Ownership is not passed. The lease term of motor vehicle 4 years. Lifetime is given 5 years. Ownership of motor vehicle is not passed. If ownership is not passed, we have to use to calculate depreciation lower period. Therefore, here lower period equal lease period. And given lease interest for 4 year period, lease interest for 4 year period, down payment and current year installment has been paid, but no adjustment has been made in this regards in the books of accounts. Think about normally 5 steps will be applied. First one, down payments. Second one, initial lease liability. Third one, current interest. Fourth one, current installment. Fifth one, annual depreciation. Right? Think what? This is requirements. Steps, think about. Think about down payments. Think about initial lease liability. Think current lease interest. Then current installment. As well as think about depreciation. Those are the information we have records. Think like this information. First one, think about down payments. Company going to purchase 12 million motor vehicle. And down payment, rupees 4 million has to be paid. It has given down payment and current installment has been paid. Therefore, down payment equal 4 million. That is step number one. When we are going to record in the ledger accounts, down payment should be accorded from the beginning. Second one, initial lease liability. 12 million fair value, but as a down payment, 4 million should be paid. Then balance part, 8 million. Therefore, initial lease liability equal 8 million. How to calculate? Initial lease liability, 12 million minus 4 million. 12 million minus 4 million. This is the way you have to calculate initial lease liability. Then current year mean 20 and 21 periods. Our accounting period end of the year 31st March 21. Therefore, current year 20 and 21 period, it has given interest values in 1000, rupees 8 and 1000. Then current year lease installment equal 2.5 million. Current year lease installment equal 2.5 million. And depreciation should be calculated. Cost value is given 12 million. Residual value is not given. Ownership is not passed. Therefore, lower period. Lower period equal 4. You have to compare with lease period and lifetime. Cost value equal 12 million. Try to calculate annual depreciation. 12 million cost value. Residual value is not given. Divided by lower period equal 4. Reason ownership is not passed. If ownership is passed, divide by lifetime. Therefore, here depreciation equal 3 million. Those are the things should be records. Down payments. Think about normally there are 6 marks available here. Right, then prepare the ledger accounts. There are ledger accounts, motor vehicle accounts, cash accounts, lease credit accounts, as well as lease interest accounts, motor vehicle depreciation expense, and accumulated depreciation. Normally, there are 6 ledger accounts we have to prepare. Right, prepare the ledger accounts, motor vehicle accounts. Lease credit accounts, lease interest accounts, then cash accounts, as well as motor vehicle depreciation expense. First one, motor vehicle account, it is equal right of use asset. Right of use asset, right of use asset. Within brackets, motor vehicle. Only right available for use. Right of use asset. Asset purchased under finance lease cannot be considered as a property, plant and equipment. You have to disclose as a separate asset under non-current assets. As a right of use asset. It is equal motor vehicle. But it should not be considered as a property, plant and equipment. Right available for use. Right of use. Then lease creditor, that's a liability. Lease credit accounts. As less lease interest became expense, therefore lease interest accounts. Lease creditor, lease interest. And cash accounts, motor vehicle depreciation expense accounts, motor vehicle depreciation expense, as well as accumulated depreciation of motor vehicle. Accumulated depreciation of motor vehicle. Accumulated depreciation of motor vehicle. Those are the ledger accounts you have to prepare. Cash accounts and lease interest accounts, lease creditor, as less right of use asset. Right, first one, down payment, it has given for 1,000. Paid in cash for motor vehicle. Record values in 1,000. Therefore, motor vehicle increase, motor vehicle account debit, cash account credit. Down payment, at the time of purchase, we have to pay down payment for motor vehicle. Motor vehicle increase, cash decrease. Motor vehicle account capital balance. Therefore, right of use asset account debit 4,000. As a cash. It is not debit for lease creditor. This is the way we have record based on new syllabus. Cash right of use asset account debit, cash account credit. Paid in cash at the time of purchase. Therefore, here name of other ledger account as right of use asset. As right of use assets. As a right of use assets. Cash account credit, right of use asset account debit. That is a motor vehicle. Step number one. Second one, think about initial lease liability. Initial lease liability, think double entry. It has not paid in cash. That value payable for lease credit, leasing company. It is also effect for motor vehicle increase. Motor vehicle fair value equal 12 million. Therefore, motor vehicle account debit 8,000 also. Effect for motor vehicle increase, but it has not paid in cash. Therefore, lease creditor credit. Motor vehicle account debit, lease creditor credit. This is the way you have to record initial lease liability. Lease credit 8,000. Lease credit 8,000 as a right of use asset. Think how to record initial lease liability and down payment. Then third one, current year is interest. It has given interest for 4 year period. Current year mean 2020 and 2021. Next year interest not became expense this year. Next year interest should be considered as expense next year. Only this year expense should be considered as expense. Therefore, this year interest expense equal 800. It should be interest also we have to pay to the leasing company. Therefore, interest expense account debit, lease, credit or credit. Interest expense account debit 800 and lease credit or credit 800. That value also should be paid to the leasing company. Interest expense account debit, lease credit or credit. Therefore, here as lease interest, name of other accounts. And lease interest account debit as a lease credit. Lease interest also we have to pay to the leasing company. This is the third steps. After that, interest installment. Installment paid in cash to the leasing company. Think about steps also. First one, down payment, cash account credit, lease, right of asset account debit. Second one, initial lease liability, right of use asset account debit, lease credit credit. Third one, current interest, lease interest account debit, lease credit credit. Now fourth one, current year lease installment. Current year lease installment is given. Current year lease installment equal to 2500. Paid in cash to the leasing company. Cash account credit, lease credit or debit, 2500. Lease credit or debit, 2500 as a cash. Step number four. Step number four. Effect for cash decrease, therefore cash account credit. Cash account credit, lease credit or debit, 2500. Paid for lease creditor. That is step number four. Now leasing adjustment, okay. And record depreciation also. Annual depreciation thing, how to calculate? It is depend on ownership of asset is passed or not. If ownership of asset is passed to the company, divided by useful lifetime. If ownership of asset is not passed to the company, divided by lower period, lower, not lease period. Sometime we have to divide by lifetime also. Therefore, think about lower period. Very important. They are MCQ paper. Right. Depreciation equal 3000. Depreciation expense account debit. Accumulated depreciation account credit. 3000. Motor vehicle depreciation expense account debit 3000. As accumulated depreciation, step number 5. And accumulated depreciation account credit as a motor vehicle depreciation. Accumulated depreciation account credit as a motor vehicle depreciation. Name of other ledger accounts. Depreciation normal way should be records. This is step number 5. Think how to record the ledger accounts. Now think about lease creditor. Very, very important. Lease creditor balance should be carried down. It should be recognized separately as a current and non-current liability. Right. Credit side increase, take total amount of credit side and take that value debit side. Take that value debit side. Difference value as a balance carry down. This one minus this one, take the answer. Difference value should be considered as a closing balance, 6,300. It should be recognized separately as a current and non-current also. And that value balance brought forward. Balance brought forward 6,300. When we are going to disclose in the financial position, it should be recognized separately as a current and non-current liability. Therefore, you have to know how to recognize lease creditor as a current liability as less non-current liability. Lease creditors should be included under non-current liability. Under non-current liability. Think how much? Bank loan also should be separate like this. Reason bank loan also we have to settle. Loan ek gatto tapo given hona pi. Leasing also like that. Next year also we have to settle. Therefore next year settlement should be included under current liability. Balance part under non-current liability. Therefore under current non-current liability. As let's think about under current liability. Under current liability. Lease creditors should be recognized separately, current liability as well as non-current liability. This value, think how much should be record current liability and how much should be record non-current liability. Lease creditors should be recognized separately. Think under current liability should be recorded installment minus next year interest. See the example. This is installment equal 2500. Think about this value. As well as next year interest. Think how much should be included under current liability. Installment minus next interest. Current interest became expense. Therefore, 2500 minus next year interest. That is a value should be included under current liability as a lease creditor. Record it. 2500, that is a lease installment. From that value should be deducted. Next year interest. Next year interest equal. Next year interest value equal 600. Think loan also like that. Installment minus next interest. That is a value should be included under current liability. Bank loan also. Therefore, installment minus next interest equals 600. Therefore, this is the value should be included under current liability. Total liability equals 6,300. Therefore, from that value should be deduct this one. That is a non-current liability. Total liability equals 6,300. From that value should be deduct 1,900. Take the answer. That is a non-current liability. 6,300 minus 1,900. 4,400. Therefore, this value should be included under current liability. This one should be included under non-current liability. Think lease credit, how to disclose? 2 marks available. Make up it on a leasing hoyaganna me account ekak ganna nathuwa. If it has given interest like that, interest ekak me vidiyata dunno. Apita me mehema hoyaganna puluwan balanna. Installment එක මුලින් දා ගන්නවා from next year. Think about current liability. Installment equal 2500. Therefore 2500 minus next interest. Lease credit can be recognized if it has given like this, like this. If it has given interest clearly, lease credit. Current and non-current liability can be recognized directly. Account එක ගහන්න නැතුව අපිට හොයන්න පුළුවන්. හැබැයි interest එක මේ විදිහට දෙන්න ඕන. Therefore, installment 2500 minus next interest. This is a current liability. 1900. And think what next year balance 2 years also like that. Try to calculate. 2500 minus interest. Take the value 2100. And here fourth one also same way. Installment minus interest equal 2300. Gana hariyata men me dege total ekata mai non current liability wen. Non current liability. This is a current liability. Installment minus next interest. Each year interest should be deducted. Then next year value should be included under current liability and balance part non-current liability. Man may garnet 4,400 non-current liability. If it is correct, that value should be equal here total amounts. Next year it pass over. May they get total non-current liability. Think about lease initial lease liability, think about down payments, current interest, installment. Then think how to calculate annual depreciation. If ownership of asset is passed to the company, and if ownership of asset is not passed to the company. Therefore, sometime it has not given initial lease liability. Sometime it has not given initial lease liability. But given down payments, fair value is not given. Installment is given. And discount factor. Think about last lesson, capital investment decision. It has given discount factor. Discount factor and lease installment is given. Therefore, installment into discount factor, it total amount equal initial lease liability. Think about like that, if it has given, in make what a balance. Sometime it has not given fair value, but it has given annual installment. Annual installment. Just think about this one. Sometime it has given paper. Think about year 1 to 2. Asset can be used for a year period. And installment it has given 2,500. Annual lease installment. Annual lease installment is given 2,500. Very important. Time I will not know. Each installment equal 2,500 for four year periods. Then sometime it has given discount factor. This is the annual lease installment. Annual lease installment. Annual lease installment. Then it has given discount factor also. Discounting factor. Think about last lesson. Capital investment decision. Discounting factor it has given at 10% rate. This is the lease-in, not present value calculation. Discount factor, think about year 1, 0.9 like that. It has given 0.8. This is the present value of 1 rupee. Therefore, this one into this one can be calculated present value. It total amount equal initial lease liability. Therefore, this one into this one take answer here. It total amount equal initial lease liability plus down payment equal fair value. That is the way you have to calculate. Sometime it has not given fair value. It has given like that annual installment and discount factor. This one into this one, it total value equal initial lease liability. In this example, think about initial lease liability. Therefore, initial lease liability plus down payment equal fair value. Think how to calculate initial lease liability. Sometime it has given like that. Think about present value of minimum lease payments. Present value of minimum lease payments plus down payments equal fair value of assets. Sometime it has not given fair value, like this also given. Some example I will discuss later, just think about. Right, this is the way your record lease in, and right of use asset, this one balance carry down, take credit side, difference value as a balance carry down. Think how to disclose if it has given company sum, balance carry down, balance carried out. Balance brought forward that value here as a balance brought forward. Lease credit current liability, non-current liability. Lease interest expense should be close. That value should be include finance expense. Finance expense. Therefore, here as income statement. Think on lease payment. Payment for lease credit also should be included under financial activities. This is a loan. Lease is also like a loan. If it has given cash flow statement, payment for lease credit should be included under financial activities. Financial. And cash and depreciation should be included income statement, as well as accumulated depreciation should be deduct from cost value. It should be included right of use of lease assets. Therefore, asset purchase under finance lease should not be considered as a property, plant and equipment. Should be disclosed separately. Right available for use, right of use of lease assets. But think about asset purchase under finance lease also should be considered as asset based on substance or form concepts. Substance or form. And very important, by recognizing assets purchase under finance lease, qualitative characteristic of faithful representation is protected. By recognizing asset purchase under finance lease, faithful representation is protected. Right. Now think about EPF adjustment. Mangika khadana minu EPF amaru ganak thiyena. Think about this one 20. Very, very important. First one, read carefully question number 20. Think how to answer. Una taama exam ekak awilla naha me wage. Godak lamai karanne accounts monawath hadanne naha. Kelima hoyenawa EPF contribution of employer and employee. E deke total ekak danawa current liability wala. Anne lamainta tama me hadanne. Question number 20, read carefully. Trial balance, it has given salary. Therefore, you have to recognize net or gross salary. It is depend on EPF contribution of employee. If EPF contribution of employee, think what's double entries. First one, net salary, cash account credit, salary account debit. Second one, EPF contribution of employee, salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. Therefore, EPF contribution of employee also part of salary. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. Anne kintama hoya ganna. Contribution of employee double entry tamai. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. Therefore, if EPF contribution of employee has been recorded, trial balance available gross salary. If EPF contribution of employee has not been recorded, trial balance we can see net salary. And given EPF payable, ETF payable account balance also available. EPF expense, ETF expense account balance available. Think about first one, EPF expense, ETF expense account balance available. Why? Effect for expense account employer contribution. Why it has given balance in the trial balance? Part of contribution of employer has been recorded. Part of contribution of employer has been recorded. And EPF payable account, ETF payable account balance available. Why? Tama central bank ekata yavalana. Those values should be paid to the central bank each month. Contribution should be transferred to the central bank. Paid in cash to the central bank. And given EPF paid, ETF paid. Onna yavala thiyena gana. Payable amount ekak yavawoth salli walin cash account credit, EPF payable account should be debit. But erroneously debited to the EPF paid, ETF paid accounts. Those are the value paid in cash to the central bank. What is the correct double entry? Cash account credit, EPF payable account debit. Cash account credit, ETF payable account debit. But it has debited to the separate ledger accounts. You can have a mass contribution ekak yawanna ona central bank ekata. Ehe thiyenne fund ekak. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit, EPF expense account debit, EPF payable account credit. Ita passe payable account ekata thiyena balance ekak cash account credit, payable account debit. Payable ekak harinam balance ekak enna ba. Mewa yawanna ona central bank ekata. Balance ekak thiyenawa kiyana eke mean ekak thama yawala na. Then godak lamai karanne kelimma contribution of employee and employee hoyala e deke total ekak danawa current liability wala ehema danne yawala naththam avuruddama yawala nathi wenna ba හැම මාසෙම මේ මාසෙක යවන්න ඊළඟ මාසෙ අඩුම ගන්න. ඒතර අන්තිම මාසෙව විතරයි හරිනම් තියෙන්නේ. Think what we have to prepare information annually. Salary should be paid monthly. Therefore EPF payable ETF payable account balance එක මොකක්ද කියලා එහෙම අපිට කලින් කියන්න බෑ. Right. Right now see the additional information. EPF contribution of employee 15% and employee 10% of the gross salary of the employees and ETF contribution of employer 5% of the gross salary of the employees and contribution of employee has not been recorded for entire year. Very very important. Contribution of employee has not been recorded for entire year. Think about contribution of employee salary account debit EPF payable account credit. අන්නේම record කරලා නැත්තම් මේ salary account එකේ තියෙන සල්ලි වලින් ගෙවපු ගන්න. Salary account entries දෙකයි යන්නේ. First one net salary, cash account credit, salary account debit. Second one contribution of employee, salary account debit EPF payable account credit. तो मैं क्या बोलते किया ना वाह contribution of employee record करना नहीं थी EPF contribution of employee has not been recorded only employee give their contribution for EPF therefore salary account debit EPF payable account credit like that has not been recorded but trial balance it has given salary account balance that is a net salary think how to decide it has not given clear It is depend on EPF contribution of employee. If EPF contribution of employee has not been recorded, trial balance available net salary. Has been recorded, trial balance available gross salary. Therefore, now you have to prepare salary accounts. EPF expense, EPF payable, ETF expense and ETF payable, as well as EPF paid, ETF paid also. Paid account also you have to prepare. Sometimes it is given in the company some like this as EPF paid, ETF paid, debit side. Those are the value paid in cash to the central bank. Cash account credit, EPF payable account debit, payable accounts. But those are debited to the separate ledger accounts, and those value now should be transferred to the payable accounts. That first one prepare the ledger accounts. Normally we have to prepare 5 ledger accounts, but now. Additional 2 accounts we have to prepare. It has given EPF paid and ETF paid also in the ledger in the trial balance. It means they are double entry. Right now, prepare the ledger accounts, salary accounts, EPF expense accounts, EPF expense. And EPF payable, those are the normal ledger accounts. As well as ETF expense, ETF expense, and ETF payable accounts. ETF expense and ETF payable and trial balance available EPF paid ETF paid also ledger account available trial balance therefore you have to prepare EPF paid and ETF paid also balance is also given EPF paid and ETF paid First one, take the balances. Salary account balance it has given 630,000. Debit side 630,000 salary. As a balance, brought forward. And EPF payable, ETF payable also given balance. EPF payable 8,000, ETF payable 25,000. EPF payable 8,000, credit side. 80,000. As a balance brought forward. And ETF payable, it has given 25,000. ETF payable accounts, 25,000 credit balance. As well as ETF expense account also given 25,000. Take as balance brought forward. ETF expense account also as balance brought forward. And ETF expense account also it has given 80,000 balance. As a balance brought forward debit side. $80,000 and EPF paid also given. Think about expense account debit side balance available and EPF paid. You can make $80,000 well in central bank. You get a give a thing on me in Harina cash account credit. EPF payable account should be debit, but it has debited to the separate ledger accounts. Therefore, now it has available trial balance. There were double entry. Therefore, now it should be recorded as a balance brought forward. Make a harinan debit pin tibune, EPF payable, ETF payable. But erroneously debited to the separate ledger accounts. Now it should be correct. Like those values should be included as a balance brought forward now. Reason there were double entry ledger accounts available. This is a trial balance. EPF paid account debit side 60,000. ETF paid account debit side 20,000. Take the balances paid account also. EPF paid account balance available 60,000 as a balance brought forward debit side. And ETF paid account it has given 20,000 as a balance brought forward. Right, first one take the balances available in the trial balance. Now think calculation part. You have to calculate EPF contribution of employer, ETF contribution of employer, as well as EPF contribution of employee. First one, as a salary trial balance available net salary, how to recognize it has given contribution of employee has not been recorded. Contribution of employee has not been recorded. Therefore, as a salary available, trial balance net salary. First one, try to calculate gross salary. Try to calculate gross salary. Trial balance it has given net salary. It has given contribution of employee has not been recorded. Therefore, contribution of employee equal 10%. It means if gross salary 100, think what if gross salary 100 deducted contribution of employee. Therefore, net salary equal 90. Net salary mean contribution of employee should be deducted from gross salary. From gross salary deduct contribution of employee. If gross salary 100, contribution of employee equal 10%, therefore net salary equal 90. Therefore, gross salary can be calculated. Think about gross salary, how to calculate. Gross salary equal 630,000, that is a net salary, divided by 90 into 100. Think about contribution of employee should be deduct when business going to calculate net salary. Contribution of employee should be deduct from gross salary and balance part paid in cash. Therefore, if gross salary 100, deducted contribution of employee, it is equal 10%. In this situation, net salary equal 90. Therefore, it has given net salary, that value divided by 90 into 100, gross salary can be calculated. Therefore, gross salary equal here 700,000. Based on that value, you have to calculate contribution of employer as well as employee for EPF and ETF. First one, calculate value. Value should be calculated from the beginning. Therefore, gross salary we know based on that value. Think about EPF contribution of employer. EPF employee as less employer. Employee and employer as less ETF, only employer. Gross salary we know, based on gross salary value should be calculated. Therefore, gross salary equals 700,000. Based on that value, it has given employee percentage equal 10% and employer percentage equal 15%. As less ETF employer only, it has given 5%. Right now, based on gross salary value equal here 10% should be calculated. Think about value. Based on gross salary, value should be calculated. Think about 700,000 into 15%. And 700,000 into 5%. Therefore, here 700,000. Here 105,000. As well as here value equal 35,000. Right now think about double entry. Value should be calculated based on gross salary. First one, contribution of employee, think about double entry. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. Contribution of employee, salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. 70,000. Therefore salary account debit 70,000 as a EPF payable. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. EPF payable account credit 70,000 as salary. This is the contribution of employee. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. And contribution of employer, value equal 105,000. But now it has given expense account balance available. EPF expense account balance available. What is the meaning? Part of contribution of employer has been recorded. Very important. EPF expense account also it has given balance. It means part of contribution of employer has been recorded. Therefore, think about contribution of employer correct value equal 105,000. This is the value should be considered as expense. But already expense account balance available 80,000. Therefore, now 105,000 total value cannot be recorded again. Expense account maximum value should be equal 105,000. Balance available in the EPF expense account, it means part of contribution of employer has been recorded. Therefore, only difference value should be recorded. Difference value equal here 25,000. Therefore, EPF expense account should be debit only 25,000. Now 105,000 cannot be debit again. Reason it has given balance, It means part of contribution of employer has been recorded already. ඇයි මාසෙ මාසෙ රෙකෝඩ් කරන්න ඕන අපි? හරිනම් අන්තිම මාසෙ විතරයි ඉතුරු වෙන්න ඕන. ඇයි හැම මාසෙම double entry එකක් කරන්න ඕන? Right. If it has given balance in the expense account, it means part of contribution of employer has been recorded. Contribution of employer value equal 105,000, but it has given balance in the expense accounts. Therefore, difference value should be recorded. Difference value equal to 25,000. Therefore, EPF expense account debit as EPF payable and EPF payable account credit. Think about difference value. 105,000 minus 80,000. EPF payable account also same value. EPF payable account credit 25,000 same value as a EPF expense. As EPF expense, think about double entry. EPF expense account debit, EPF payable account credit. Then next one, ETF. Think about EPF contribution of employee salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. Contribution of employer, EPF expense account debit, EPF payable account credit. ETF only employer contribution. ETF employer contribution equal 35,000. ETF also expense. ETF expense account debit, ETF payable account credit. But if it has given balance in the expense account, payable ke nevi balanne, expense account ke thama balanna api. If it has given ETF expense account balance, it means part of contribution of employer has been recorded. Therefore, 35,000. Expense account balance available 25,000. Therefore, difference value 10,000. Think what correct value equal 35,000. This is value should be considered as expense in the ETF expense accounts. ETF expense account as a balance should be considered as expense should be considered 35,000. But already it has given balance. It has given balance 25,000 expense accounts. But expense account total value should be equal to 35,000. Part of contribution of employer has been recorded. Therefore, only difference value 10,000. ETF expense account debit as ETF payable. ETF payable account credit as ETF expense 10,000. ETF expense account debit, ETF payable account credit as ETF expense. Think about expense account debit, payable account credit. Difference value. This is the way you have records. Think about expense account. If it has correctly recorded salary account, correct value should be equal plus salary. Now no need to prepare salary control accounts. Salary control account you have to prepare in the pay sheets. But here salary expense accounts. If it has correctly recorded salary account, value should be equal gross salary. EPF and ETF expense account value should be equal contribution of employer. හැබැයි payable එකේ balance එක මොකද්ද කියලා අපිට එහෙම කියන්න බෑ. මොකද ඒවා central bank එකට යවන්න ඕන. යවලා නම් balance එකක් නැහැ. යවලා නැත්නම් තමයි balance එකක් එන්නේ. ඒක අපිට කියන්න බෑ මොකක්ද තියෙන balance එක තියෙන්න ඕනේ කියලා කියන්න බෑ. But definitely salary account gross salary if it has correctly recorded and EPF and ETF expense accounts contribution of employer. Now think paid amounts. It has given EPF paid, ETF paid. Think about EPF payable account. EPF payable account may tama given no gana central bank. If it has paid in cash, cash account credit, EPF payable account debit. But it has given trial balance as EPF paid and ETF paid. This is the value paid in cash to the central bank. Those values should be debited, should be debit payable accounts. Cash account credit, EPF payable account debit. Cash account credit, ETF payable account debit. but those are debited erroneously in the EPF paid accounts. Therefore, now that value should be transferred to the payable accounts. Harinan debit wenna tibune EPF ETF payable accounts, but debited separately the accounts. Therefore, now it should be transferred to the payable accounts. Think about EPF paid account debit side available. It should be debit EPF payable accounts. Therefore, now transferred. This one credit 60,000. EPF paid account credit as a EPF payable. EPF paid account credit as an EPF payable and EPF payable account debit. එකන මේ ගිල දෙන cash account credit EPF paid account debit වෙලා තියෙන. හරිනම් debit වෙන්න ඕනේ cash account credit EPF payable accounts. EPF payable accounts should be debit but debited EPF paid accounts. Therefore that value should be transferred to the EPF payable. EPF paid account credit as EPF payable, EPF payable account debit as EPF paid now. Harinan cash ke liye yanna one, but now it has debited to the EPF paid accounts. Therefore, EPF paid account credit, EPF payable account debit. Therefore, EPF paid here, name of other ledger accounts. Now cannot be written as a cash. Harinan cash ke liye yanna one. Cash account credit, EPF payable account debit. But it has debited already EPF paid accounts. Therefore, that value should be transferred to the EPF payable accounts. ETF paid also same way. ETF paid also, it has given debit side balance. That value should be transferred to the ETF payable accounts. Therefore, debit side available, that value credit. Therefore, ETF paid account credit as an ETF payable. It should be transferred now for ETF payable accounts. Therefore, ETF payable account debit, ETF payable account debit 20,000 as ETF paid. Think paid amount, cash account credit, payable account debit, but those are debited erroneously separately the accounts. Now think about EPF paid account, there is no balance. Both side equal. Main account yak inne ne. වරද්දලා මේක වල දාලා තියෙන. හරිනම් වෙන්න තිබුණේ cash account credit EPF payable account තමයි debit වෙන්න තිබුණේ. But erroneously debited to the EPF paid accounts. That value should be transferred to the EPF payable ETF payable. Right now think about ledger accounts. Salary accounts 700,000 debit side increase. Take that value credit side. Think about salaries expense. All the income and expense account should be closed. All the income and expense account should be closed. All the income and expense account should be closed. Therefore, take debit side total amounts and take that value credit side difference value as income statement. Income statement. This value should be included under administration expense. If it is trading business, if it is manufacturing business, under production overheads or direct wages. If it is machine operator, this value should be included direct wages. If it is manager, if it is supervisor, this value should be included production overheads. If it is trading business, this value should be included under administration expense. Salary meten denakala ehema apita kiyanna ba. It is depend on business. And ETF expense also expense 105,000. If it is correct, it should be equal contribution of employer. Expense, all the expense should be closed. Closed mean difference value as income statement. Difference value as income statement. And payable account is a liability. Balance carried out. One example on payable ke aradena ke total ke denne kila balan. Payable account balance. අපිට කියන්න බෑ කලින් මොකද්ද මේකේ බැලන්ස් එක කියලා. Let take the value credit side increase. difference value balance carry down. Therefore, credit side total money equal 175,000. Take that value debit side. And difference value, this one minus this one, 115,000. That is the value should be recorded as a balance carry down. That value balance brought forward credit side. अने यावाला नैतिक तमा में इन्हें मेके तेरु में तमाई थाम सेंट्रल बैंक के यावाला ने यावन नॉन इफ इट इज पेड इन कैश कैश अकाउंट क्रेडिट पेबल अकाउंट डेबिट एक ने पेबल के बैलेंस का इन्ना पुलवा नती वेन्ना पुलवा हरी नंग इन्ना बे उनको देवा यावन नॉन सेंट्रल बैंक के मई मासे यावन बेरुनो अडुम गाने ईलंग मासे यावन नॉन राइट ईपीएफ एक्सपेंस एक्सपेंस इफ इट इज करेक्टली रिकॉर्डेड वैल्यू शुड बी इक्वल कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ एम्प्लॉयर. Therefore, 35,000 as a income statement under administration expense. If it is direct wages, if EPF and ETF relevant for matching operator salary, this fund should be included in the manufacturing accounts under direct wages. EPF and ETF also, again, garment factory ka naang, and the mahana kaatti ita given EPF ka naam me, EYN ne direct wages valad. Supervisor and managers like you are overhead world. All other employees should be included administration. And EPF payable balance part, credit side equal 35,000. Take that value debit side. Difference value balance carry down. Difference value balance carry down. Therefore equal 15,000. That value balance brought forward credit side. Balance brought forward. Therefore, this is where you should be included financial position under current liability. There are 5 marks available, but EPF paid account, ETF paid account, there is no balance. Both side equal. Therefore, debit side total amount equal credit side. ETF paid also same way. Debit side total amount equal. Debit side total amount equal 20. Take that value credit side, both side equal. Right, prashna thinna gahanna balan. Ithuru tika gedarin hadanna. Prashna naththam api physical class ekedi hambemu next week.